In my last video, I made this XY table for the belt grinder. And in this video, I'm going to show you how I made these clamps, which enable it to grind really large and odd-shaped workpieces, as well as really tiny workpieces, like this one, that would not be safe to hold otherwise. And I'll show you how I made this magnetic chuck, which allows you to grind parallel faces on steel parts. With this chuck, this acts as a surface grinding attachment. I'm going to show making the mag chuck first because that's probably what most of you are here for, but I actually recommend making the hold down clamps first because you'll need to use them while making the mag chuck.
Let's first have a look at the plans. Got the cover page with the index, some notes here, contact information in case you need to ask me questions, some information about CNC cutting the parts if you want to. Super optional, of course. Here is a table to help you decide on the length that you want to make your mag chuck. You can always make the chuck shorter than the table, just not longer. So it has the maximum length of table that each length of chuck can fit on. Keep this table around because you're going to be referencing this throughout the build. A shopping list, both for the materials and for the hardware. A cutting list with templates that you can print out and paste onto the material. The template for the table surface. You can tile a couple of these together to make it longer if you need a longer one. And then you have the assembly instructions. It's pretty straightforward, so this is not a very long set of plans. And then on the last page, you have just a bit of information about how to use your chuck.
So here I'm referencing that table on page 3 to see what length to cut this piece to, and this will be the main structure of the mag chuck. Here I'm using the XY table to grind it down to final length. I really love using the XY table for bringing things to final length and squaring the ends. This template is already the right length for the shortest of the mag chucks, but for any of the longer ones, just cut it in half and paste one end to each end of the angle iron. I designed it so that these slots can be cut in from the edge of the workpiece because that's a lot easier than cutting between two holes. And then later in the build, I'll be welding this piece across the end of those slots to close them up and make them close slot again. These get a 1/4-20 tapped hole. I'm using a block of wood to keep my tap straight, and we make two identical ones of those.
So what we want to do now is grind this end perfectly flush because this needs to be exactly the same length from the center of the bolt to this end on both parts. The outer profile doesn't really matter.
And once again, using the XY table for this, it really works great for grinding two pieces to the same profile because you can just clamp them both down together. And even though I just said that the outer profile doesn't really matter, I'm grinding the two of them at the same time just to make them identical because why not? Now those are done, and the only custom part that's left to make is the magnetic surface. For longer magnetic surfaces, you'll tile two templates together, like I'm showing here, but I'm just making one this length. Those are all of the screw holes. Now we can drill out the actual holes for the magnets. Before drilling all of them, I check that the magnets actually fit. I found that my drill bit was raising quite a burr on the backside, so I just deburred those all with a countersink as I went so that it would stay sitting flat on the table while I drilled. They're gonna have to be deburred anyways so that this part will sit flat against the angle iron surface later. I countersink the screw holes so that the screw will sit well below the surface.
Okay, I've got all of my components from the shopping list and the cutting list. We can now start on the assembly.
We want the registration pins to be a known distance apart so that we can use trigonometry to set up angles. So in this case, I'm making them 8 inches apart.
Everything is clamped down flat to the table, and I made sure to press both of the parts together so that the registration pin hole is going to be the same distance from the front face on both of these. We're going to regrind this front face to make it perfectly parallel, but we want to start with it as close as possible.
I want a bolt to be able to slide down the full length of this slot, and this weld is interfering, so I'll grind that down. You could definitely use an angle grinder for this, but I hate angle grinders, so I used the belt grinder. And then I did a bit more cleanup on the slots, and now the bolt slides nicely. We need to grind the bottom of this weldment totally flat so that it sits flat on the table. I'm using a dial indicator to set it up so that it runs true. This is just to reduce the amount of grinding I have to do, trying to get it as straight as possible before I start grinding. Here I'm installing the two socket head cap screws that act as the registration pins, and then I can just push those against the edge of the table and bolt the mag chuck down. And then here I'm re-grinding that back face so that it's nice and true to the rest of the machine. This also gets rid of the mill scale and gives me a nice flat surface for the magnets to sit flat against, which in theory should improve the magnetic circuit a little bit. And man, I love the shiny parts that come off of this thing. This never gets old.
When you clamp the aluminum down to the steel, make sure that it's not overhanging the edge of the steel here. Otherwise, the mag chuck will not sit flat on the table because it'll be hanging up on the aluminum. It's best to have the aluminum set back this way a little bit from the edge of the steel.
And now that I have that aluminum surface clamped where I want it, I can go ahead and transfer all of the hole locations and also mark the orientation that the aluminum was in so that I can put it back in the same orientation. And now I'm drilling all of those holes through, and I'll tap them. The screws that I'm using to hold the aluminum surface on are very mildly magnetic. You don't want them to be strongly magnetic, like this plain steel screw is. Ideally, these would be completely non-magnetic, but I'm just using plain stainless steel screws that I found at the hardware store, and these are really easy to find and they're good enough. And now we're ready to start dropping the magnets in. I have the whole stick of magnets with a piece of tape on the top of the stick to make sure that I don't flip the orientation, putting in all of the south-facing magnets first, and then I'll come back and do all of the north-facing ones. I'm just putting the stick in just far enough for the last magnet to get scraped off, and then it drops into the hole on its own. That's all of the south-facing magnets done, so I'm moving the tape to the other end of the stack so that I can do all of the north-facing ones.
Try not to let the entire stick of magnets fall into the hole like I've done here, because it is practically impossible to get this one that's halfway in back out. Because of the neighboring magnets, they're helping to hold that one in. So yeah, the stack always wants to break here and not at the magnet below this one. I'm pretty much stuck with trying to get it out with pliers, which is kind of dangerous because you can chip or shatter the magnets.
Yeah, success.
That's why I'm being very careful to only let the first one in and then scrape it off sideways.
If you do get two magnets stuck in there and you don't want to use pliers to get them out, you can always just remove the aluminum surface and carefully slide that magnet off the edge and put the aluminum back.
Okay, all done. Don't expect it to hold too well just yet because we need to surface it so that the actual surface is closer to the magnets, but it already does hold decently well.
Now we're going to fill in all of the holes on the surface with high temperature epoxy. This is JB Weld Original. It's rated at 550 degrees. It doesn't need to have quite that high of a rating, but it should be at least 300 degrees Fahrenheit. JB Weld is magnetic, which is kind of fun to play with.
If anything, these magnetic properties should improve the holding power of the mag chuck, but they're not necessary for it to work.
Do your best to not get air bubbles in it. You'll probably get a couple, but the fewer the better. Okay, the epoxy is cured, and now before I grind this, I'm going to give it a coat of paint. So I'm removing the two screws. And I essentially just painted the entire thing. We put the screws back in, and now we're ready to surface the chuck, and then it'll be ready to use. I very strongly recommend wearing a respirator while doing this. That epoxy dust is nasty. Also, keep an eye on the temperature, or a hand in this case. I'm just gripping my hands against the chuck, and if it's ever too hot to hold my hands on, I give it a break. You don't want to overheat the magnets. They're only rated at 80 degrees Celsius. The edges are very sharp after grinding, so I'm just filing them a little bit so they're not going to cut me. And that's it. let's give that a test and see how well it does. So I'm just sticking this piece directly to the magnet. I haven't offset the magnet back to create a ledge for it to sit on, but it was no problem. It didn't try to slide at all. Cleaning off the surface and flipping the piece around. And now we can grind the opposite face. There we go. Now you can watch me turn my camera off.
Since we're using the platen attachment for surface grinding, it pulls down on your workpiece. With a workpiece of this size, it's really no problem because it has enough surface in contact with the magnet that it is really securely stuck. It won't move. But if I was grinding something, let's say this small, then I have the option of offsetting the mag chuck backward to create a ledge here that the workpiece can sit against. We can put something with parallel edges under this side between the table and the registration pins. Push the mag chuck forward against that and tighten it down. That sets this up nice and parallel to the table, but now we have a ledge on the bottom, so when I put this small workpiece in here, it will get pushed down against that ledge, and now I can safely grind it. I can also use these registration pins to set up precise tapers.
Okay, that's it for the mag chuck part of this video. Now let's have a look at the hole down clamp plans, and I'll show you how to build that. These are pretty much the same layout as the mag chuck plans, so I'm not really going to talk too much about them. I'm going to make two of these clamps, and I'm going to make them in two different ways. So the first one I'm going to make using the templates, and then the second one I'll do a little bit differently because I think it's actually easier to not use the templates for this project. You can see I'm kind of struggling to hold these workpieces. They're so small. That's why we're going to do the other one a little bit differently. The clamps are just these two little end blocks, and then two straight pieces of flat bar on each side, and we can just set that up on top of the template in the plans to make sure that it's the right size. And then just weld it together. Once it's welded, I grind off any excess weld from the left and right sides so that it will sit flat on the table, and then I use my second clamp to hold it down while I grind the top surface nice and flat. Now I can flip it around, use a square to set it up parallel to the edge of the table, and then I can grind the bottom edge to be parallel with the top edge. Here I'm grinding a slight recess into the middle of the clamp so that it leaves a little foot on the front and back. That way there's room for the clamp to deflect a little bit when you tighten it down. This ensures it applies the pressure right at the very ends and leaves some clearance in the middle. Now let's make that second clamp with a slightly different technique. So I have the bottom and the inside of this piece ground square and flat, and the same on this one. Bottom and inside are square and flat, and I'm just going to go ahead and clamp it all together right now.
So what matters here is that the bottom face is completely flat and this inside length is correct. All of the outside surfaces are still rough, but we'll grind those down later.
By welding all of this together while the pieces are still rough, we have way more to hold onto, so we can much more easily grind them down to the final size. And after deburring all of the edges, I can give them a coat of paint, and then they're done. These get assembled with a piece of threaded rod, a washer, and a hold-down knob, and that's it. To use them, you need to support the back end of the clamp with something that's roughly the same thickness as your workpiece. That prevents it putting any bending force on the threaded rod. The clamps can also be attached to the bottom side of the table, where they act as an adjustable end stop to limit the table's travel. And that's it. This project is done. If you haven't already seen it, go check out the build video for the XY table itself, and for sure check out the unveiling video, where I show off the features of all of these parts. There are links to both of those videos in the description. There's also a link in the description to where you can download the plans. The plans are sold as a bundle, the XY table, mag chuck, and hold down clamps all at once, and you also get CNC files. There are both inch and metric versions. Again, links in the description. Thanks for watching.